Hello everyone, welcome back to another Champions League score predictions video. A little bit late with uploading this one or making this video as the matches are tomorrow evening, but it's good that I can get this video out 24 hours before. So let's just go straight into it. And yeah, all of these Champions League games are the exact same. Basically, the reverse fixtures of match day three. Let's just have a look, at my points. Total points so far, 139. I'm currently ranked 6,500 out of 500,000 players, 600,000 players. Started off really badly with match day one and match day two. Starting to pick up the points now, so hopefully to continue the streak going. Okay, let's begin with Wolfsburg and Salzburg here. Salzburg won last time between these two. I'm going to back Salzburg to win again, but I feel like it'll be a little bit more tighter than it was last time. And I think Wolfsburg will be able to get a goal, but I'll say Salzburg will comfortably maybe be able to get the two goal, but it'll still be, you know, Wolfsburg will still have their chances. But I feel Salzburg just to edge in this one. Okay, Malmo and Chelsea. Last time was a narrow victory to Chelsea, a very narrow victory to Chelsea. Chelsea since, they've put 7 past Norwich, put 3 past Newcastle. So I'll definitely back them to win this one. I'll go 2-0 though. I think Malmo, they're not going to score one, especially with Chelsea's defence. So they'll probably just try to defend as much as possible in this one. And I think Chelsea will get a comfortable win, but not a thrashing. Okay, Sevilla and LOSC Lille. Sevilla, definitely the most popular predictions for them to get the win here. I'm going to say that they'll get a draw though. I'll say 1-1. Both teams, Spanish league facing the French league here. Both average teams in their league really. Sevilla doing quite well so far in La Liga. Obviously Real Madrid still top of the Spanish league in that one. But, you know, they're doing well in La Liga. LOSC, they managed to score against PSG before losing 2-1 in their last Ligue 1 match. Let's just move on now to Villarreal against Young Boys. I'm definitely going to back Villarreal to win this one, but I think they'll concede one though as well. So I'll go 2-1 here. Man United, Atalanta. I got this prediction right last time, alongside with quite a few others. Same with the Barcelona and Dynamo Kiev one, which we will come back to, we'll come up to in just a moment. But Atalanta, last time they played United at Old Trafford, they lost 2-3. Now the reverse fixture, them at home. I think Man United will win this one. I'll go 3-1 this time. I think United will score 3 goals again. They got 3 goals last time. They got 3 goals against Spurs. I think they'll do it again. And I think Ole Gunnar Solskjaer will keep his job at Man United. I think he'll have quite a bit of a running streak now with some good results for United, including this one here. Okay, last time out between Dynamo Kiev and Barcelona, it was 1-0 to Barcelona. Even though Barcelona, they're not the best, I still think they'll get the win in this one. I think it may be another tight one, but I'll say 2-0 this time. I said 1-0 last time, I got it right. So I think they may score another goal. They had way more chances than Dynamo Kiev in this one, so I'm going to back them to take the chances here. Okay, Bayern Munich against Benfica. Bayern Munich, such a strong squad, as well as their attack. They've got their midfield as well. I know they got thrashed 5-0 by Mönchengladbach, I think it was, that beat them 5-0 in some cup in Germany when Bayern Munich had their full strong squad out. They had Müller, Sané, Lewandowski, Kimmich, Neuer. They had the full main team out. But I think it's Bayern's turn to do the thrashing, and I'm going to go Bayern 4, Benfica 0. Juventus, Zenit. It took until around the 85th minute for Juventus to get the winning goal to win it 1-0. last time. I think Juventus, they'll get the win here. I think Juventus are a team, currently all of their goals that they have scored, well, not all of them, quite few of their goals that they've scored have been in the 80th minute, like late 80th minutes, to pick up wins, to pick up draws, or even to get consolation goals. In their Serie A matches, the Italian League, and in their Champions League matches as well. So I do think it'll be 2-1 this time. It was 1-0 last time they played. 85th minute goal. I think maybe it'll be 1-1. Juventus will snatch a winner late on, like they always do, to pick up some kind of result. In this result, I am going to say Juventus should get the win in this one. Should get the 3 points. Okay. AC Milan against Porto. Going to be a pretty tricky match, this. Milan, decent side, decent squad. Porto as well, normally a team that does very, very well in the Champions League, and no one expects them to do well every single season. They think that Porto will just end up not making it through, but then they do, and then they make it high up. They make it to the semi-finals. They knock out Juventus. They almost knock out Chelsea. And just every season, they're such a surprising club. But I am going to back Milan in this one, obviously, 2-1. But it wouldn't surprise me if Porto picks up the win in this one. Or maybe I could go for like a 2-2 draw in this one. But I'll stick with my original prediction that I have said. And then let's just move on now to Real Madrid against Shakhtar Donetsk. I think it'll be a comfortable 3-0 victory for Madrid in this game. Quickly moving on to a very exciting fixture, Liverpool against Atletico Madrid. It was 3-2 to Liverpool last time they played in Madrid. Now they're at Anfield. It's going to be a very close game, I think, still. I think there'll be loads of goals. Luis Suarez is returned to Anfield. I'm going to go for a 2-2 draw this time. I don't think there'll be anything to separate the two sides. Okay, Sporting against Besiktas. Sporting beating Besiktas 4-1 last time. I think they'll still get the victory, just a narrower scoreline, and I'll say 2-1. Man City, Club Brugge. I'm going to back City to win this one. Not 2-0. I'm going to back them 3-0. It really could be any City side that turns up, because they lost 2-0 to Crystal Palace at the Etihad, but when they do need results, when they're at the Etihad, that's the place for them to get the results that they need. The Crystal Palace game. Obviously, there's always going to be that one game that no one expects. So I think they'll come back to winning ways, and I think they'll do it comfortably. They create enough chances to score goals. They just need to put it in the back of the net. So maybe it could be 2-0, a bit more of a tight game. But if Man City put out a good squad, De Bruyne, Foden, Jesus, they should get, those should be like the goal scorers. Riyad Mahrez is in there as well, so we should be all right for getting this one. Depends which one I'm going to play my times 2 booster on as well. I'm tempted to play on the Liverpool Atletico Madrid, but we'll just finish these off first. Leipzig and PSG. I said 2-1 to PSG last time. I'm going to say it again. Yeah, I think Paris, currently, they're doing all right. They're at the top of the French league, but they are conceding goals and maybe not picking up results, as in like scoreline results. They've been these very narrow victories. And PSG, when you look at the squad, you expect them to be thrashing everyone like Man City. Even though PSG did beat Man City, Lionel Messi, with that his first goal for PSG against Man City, scoring a very good goal in that game. But really, since the win against Man City, the top teams, when they've been facing low teams in the French league, you expect them to be smashing them, but they're not. So yeah, I think it'll be a close game, especially that it's Leipzig, who isn't doing the best in the German league this season, but I still think it'll be close. Okay, Sheriff and Inter Milan. Last time Inter Milan winning 3-1, I do believe. But Sheriff still managing to score in these games, and well, they're a bit like, I feel like they're a bit like Juventus Sheriff at the moment, because they won against Shakhtar Donetsk. They beat Real Madrid 2-1, I think that game was. They always score. No, well, apart from the last time out with Inter Milan, they've always been the first team to score. And then it was very impressive, the fight back against Real Madrid, because I think Real Madrid had about 30 shots on them. And their team is just so good. And it's so... I don't know what to say about them. They're such a team that you expect that they're not going to do well at all. But yet, they surprise everyone. I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw in this one. I really do think it'll be a very tight game. And I think people need to start giving Sheriff some credit now. Now that they've shown us what they can actually do in the Champions League. That finishes us off with Dortmund against Ajax. Dortmund got smashed by Ajax last time. I think it was 4-0, 3-0 last time. I do think it'll be a draw in this game, and I do think it'll be high goal scoring. We've got Erling Haaland for Dortmund. Maybe Jude Bellingham can pop up for Ajax. Obviously, the main striker up there at the moment is Sebastian Haller. I'm going to go 3-3. Big scoreline in this one. And what am I going to play my times 2 booster on? I'm going to go for the Juventus and Zenit one. I feel like I may be correct with that. So or am I? I'm not sure. I think I'll change it to the Barcelona and Dynamo Kiev one now, actually. Yeah, I'll go with that. Okay, that's going to finish it off for match day 4 on the Champions League. Sorry I am a little bit late with this one, but hopefully I can continue my very good run now that I've started off, getting some high points and get up the world rankings. And yeah, thank you all for watching. I'll see you all next time. Bye.